Hello friends, my name is Fanindra. Today I am going to say a topic about of digestive system of Periplaneta americana. Periplaneta americana is commonly known as cockroach. So this is the structure of the digestive system of cockroach, I mean Periplaneta americana. Digestive system of Periplaneta americana mainly consists of elementary canal. Elementary canal mainly consists of three parts: foregut, midgut and hindgut. Foregut is commonly known as stomatium, midgut is commonly known as mesenterum, and hindgut is commonly known as proctoidium. So how to define elementary canal? Elementary canal is a long tube-like structure and it is a coiled in some places, and it mainly starts from mouth and ends towards anus. This is known as elementary canal. This total part is known as elementary canal. So I have said to you here that it is mainly divided into three parts: foregut, midgut and hindgut. So foregut, first let us talk about foregut. The foregut includes pharynx, esophagus, crop and gizzard. This is here. Now let us talk about pharynx. Pharynx is mainly starts from the mouth. This is the mouth part, and below the mouth the pharynx is present, and the pharynx leads to the opening of esophagus, and the esophagus is tube like structure. This is esophagus is tube like structure. This part is known as esophagus. And the esophagus leads to the opening of distensible sac-like structure, which is known as crop. And crops mainly leads to the opening into the gizzard. So, in human, the function of stomach is storage of food. In the same way, the function of crop in cockroach is storage of food. So, let us talk about gizzard. So, let us zoom the picture of the gizzard. This is a zooming picture of the gizzard. Gizzard mainly consists of six teeth. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. These are the 6 teeth which are mainly present in the gizzard. These are the teeth. And each teeth mainly consists of bristles. The fine hair-like structures which I have drawn here are known as bristles. So, the food which mainly enters into the gizzard from the crop. Here, from the crop, it enters into the gizzard. When the food enters into the gizzard, the function of teeth starts. It means it undergoes grinding. It mainly undergoes grinding so that the food which is mainly present in that gizzard will turn into fine particles. This part is known as fine particles. Here the total food which is filtered by the bristles and is grinded by the teeth will come out from the gizzard, and the food which comes out from the gizzard will enter into the next part. That is nothing but midgut. So the food which enters in, now let us talk about midgut. Midgut is commonly known as mesenteron. So midgut is narrow tube like structure. This is the midgut, which is mainly present below the gizzard. This is a gizzard, and this part is known as midgut, and it is commonly known as mesenteron. And here the part of the midgut, I mean the part where the midgut starts over, is known as ventriculus. So the midgut is of what can so what we can say midgut is commonly known as ventriculus here midgut is commonly known as ventriculus so the now food which enters into the midgut from the gizzard will enter into the midgut, and here the part which I have said here is known as ventriculus. In the part of the ventriculus, 8 finger-like projections will be arranged. They are nothing but hepatic cheekae, and the function of the hepatic cheekae is absorption of food material. These are the hepatic cheekae, hair-like structures are known as hepatic cheekae. When coming into the human, our digestive system mainly consists of finger-like projections. They are nothing but microvilli in our digestive system. What is the function of that microvilli? It mainly absorbs the for nutrients which is present in the food material. In the same way, in the cockroach, the hepatic cheekae, the function of the hepatic cheekae is absorption of food material. Now the absorbed food material will enter into the next part, I mean mesenteron. Now let us zoom the part of the mesenteron, I mean nothing but ventriculus. This is the zoomed part of the mesenteron. And the mesenteron is mainly divided into anterior secretory part. The green color which I have drawn is known as anterior secretory part, and the posterior absorptive part. The red color which I have drawn is posterior absorptive part. This is the zoom structure of here, mesenteron. This is the zoom structure of mesenteron. And at the anterior part, it mainly consists of it mainly consists of secretory cells, which I have drawn in black color dots, are known as secretory cells. So these secretory cells mainly secretes enzymes, and these enzymes mainly helps to the for helps in the formation of peritrophic membrane. So what is peritrophic membrane? It is a layer which mainly covers the bolus. For example, if you think this is a bolus, the outer structure, I mean, it mainly forms layer at the outer part. This is a layer, and this layer is known as peritrophic membrane. This is the bolus, and the outer layer is known as peritrophic membrane. So what is this peritrophic membrane? The peritrophic membrane mainly helps in the smooth movement of the bolus. When the bolus enters into like this, the bolus cannot damage, and the parts of the cockroach also cannot be damaged because of the peritrophic membrane. So the food which enters into this mesenteron and finally reaches to the next part, that is nothing but hindgut. Here hindgut is commonly known as procardium, and at the beginning of the hindgut, it mainly consists of the yellow color which I have drawn here is known as malpighiant tubules. These are the malpighiant tubules. What is the function of that malpighiant tubules? Malpighiant tubules mainly helps in the secretion of uric acid. Malpighiant tubules is mainly helpful in secretion of uric acids. Let us talk about hindgut, procardium. Hindgut, it mainly consists of three parts: ileum, colon, and rectum. This part is known as ileum. This part is known as ileum. This part is known as colon, and the final part is known as rectum. So, what is the so? Let us talk about ileum. What is the ileum? Ileum mainly receives food material from the midgut. I mean, from here, it mainly receives food material from the midgut, and it also receives uric acid, which are secreted by the malpighiant tubules. As I said to you before, that malpighiant tubules function is to secrete uric acid. It collects that uric acid from the malpighiant tubules, and it also collects food material from the mesenteron, that is nothing but midgut. And it sends the ileum sends food material, I mean waste food material, to the colon, and the colon mainly sends food material to the rectum. And at this part, the total food material, I mean, in presence of water, it mainly absorbs water. In presence of nutrients, it totally absorbs nutrients. The total, all the particles will be absorbed in the part of rectum, and then the waste material will be sent out through the anus. And this is the total structure of digestive system of Periplaneta americana. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please like and do subscribe. Thank you.